to get this to you. I went over 690 sources. So I would recommend roll that intro in order to get those goodies real quick. First, to all my beer lovers, listen away. Millions of liters of beers expired in Australia amid coronavirus has been converted into renewable energy. It powers up to 1,200 homes per week. This woman right here is a so-called daytime hero. Why? Because after the devastating explosion in Beirut, she was capable of saving not only one, but three little babies. And this is just a cute picture of a rabbit. Just to change things up a little bit. Speaking of Jane, Lord Vader, what time is it?
It's time for the Rapid Fire Pew Pew News.
Good news for tonight's entertainment. FC Barcelona is playing against Bayern Munich in a Champions League quarterfinal banger. And another good news for FC Barcelona, as two key players, namely Ousmane Dembélé and Antoine Griezmann, are back in the squad, fit to play. Ed Sheeran became a dad for the very first time. Congrats, mate, and I see you on your next concert. Zurich was amazing. Like we should get rid of bad news, we also should get rid of bad tattoos. Hence, there is a day dedicated to the sole purpose. Happy Tattoo Removal Day. Speaking of Tattoo Removal Day, earlier this week has been World's Elephant Day. Appropriate to this occasion, we are sharing the long-awaited news that a 35-year-old pachyderm who spent nearly a decade, that's full 10 years, without a playmate in a zoo, he will finally move to a new home. According to a report, if Kavan, that's the name of the elephant, is deemed healthy for travel, he will be relocated to Cambodia in the next few weeks for the rest of his beautiful life. Similar happy and delighted to hear their news are Little Grey and Little White. The two beluga whales are free for the very first time since 2011, after spending 7 years performing for audiences in Shanghai. They may have to do some wound healing. That's a great gateway to our next innovative good news. Researchers develop wound bandages that kills bacteria. And that's what it's all about. So from time to time, we humans injure ourselves. In the worst case, bacterial infections can lead to blood poisoning. This can be fatal. Researchers now have developed a new wound bandage to combat these infections directly on the wound. In concrete terms, these are very fine membranes from plants which are spun into tissue. These tissues are treated with a peptide solutions. Those are little proteins. This is very well tolerated by the human skin, but is a death sentence for bacteria. And that's it. That's it for this week. This is the good news, asking you to remember that no act of kindness is too small. Ciao! Visca el Barça! Visca el Barça!